गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम टू बॉम्बे मैनेजमेंट एसोसिएशन वेडनेसडे वेबिनार. फॉर लास्ट फ्यू मंथ्स वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग इंडियन मैनेजर्स हु मेड अ डिफरेंस. वी हैव प्रेजेंटेड टू यू द पर्सनालिटीज, टॉवरिंग पर्सनालिटीज इन मैनेजमेंट हु हैव मेड डिफरेंस टू द थिंकिंग, द थॉट प्रोसेस एंड the working of management in India. And these personalities were very closely associated with Bombay Management Association in various capacities also. We are celebrating them in order to give the young students and professionals the personalities who have made management thoughtful process and also the theory and practice. We have presented to you in the past Dr. K.S. Basu, Mr. Prakash Tandon, Shri Sharu Rangnekar, and today we have another great towering personality, Dr. P.N. Singh. And today we have with us the past presidents of Bombay Management Association, daughters of Dr. P.N. Singh, the students and director of Parle Tirak Vidyalaya's Associations Institute of Management, who have worked to create this audio visual for Dr. P.N. Singh. The format of our Wednesday Wisdom webinar today will be same. First, we will have a look at the audio visual that is created by the students of Parle Tirak Vidyalaya Associations Institute of Management under the guidance of Dr. Harish Kumar Purohit, the director, Jigar Patel, professor, and the student group who had worked on this personality. After that, we will have the experiences and the learnings from many people who had worked with Dr. P.N. Singh and also had had fortune to work with him, under him. So we welcome you all once again for this Wednesday Wisdom webinar, celebrating Indian managers who made a difference. And today we are presenting to you Dr. P.N. Singh. May I request Dr. Harish Kumar Purohit to say a few words, and then we will have the audio visual. Over to you, Dr. Purohit.
Thank you. Good evening, madam. Respected president, current president, past presidents, and dear friends, student friends, colleagues. It is an honor for all of us at PTVH Institute of Management to work on Dr. P.N. Singh, especially not only his journey started from Bulakkad to Mercedes in terms of books that our students and all of us have read. It is most important that how to live life and how to make others motivate, how to inspire others and make them their journey smooth. These are the key qualities with value systems that it is there in our country and our ethos that drive the whole momentum of a life, and the people him has made that mark on the life of people around him. So we are all proud to be associated with this important, not only BMA event, but the personality called Singh Sir. And we are fortunate that his daughters are also going to share their learned experience. And our students, Jigar Sir, have done wonderful job. BMA presidents, past presidents have guided all of us. And I'm sure all of you will like it. And this is going to be another learning in our cap. Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you, Dr. Purohit. We are very happy that PTVA's Institute of Management has participated in this, and the students have got the opportunity to have a close look at the personality which they are going to present. So over to Omkar Kanerkar for the audio visual. My appreciation to the student team for creating this audio visual, and we are very eager to see that. So over to you, Omkar. Please play the video.
Good evening, everyone. We at the Bombay Management Association and PTVS Institute of Management welcome you to the Wednesday Wisdom Webinar on celebrating Indian managers who made a difference. They say, if your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more and become more, you are a leader. And today, we are celebrating one such leader who has inspired, molded, encouraged and aided thousands of lives. Dr. P.N. Singh, the LED formula that is learn throughout your life, earn as much as you can and distribute continuously what you have learned and what you have earned was proposed by Dr. P.N. Singh by which he molded his way of life. Dr. P.N. Singh was born on 29 January 1941 in rural Bihar and his entire childhood was spent in a dusty village called Ganjpur. His schooling was done in a local village school in the vernacular medium. He had the perseverance to keep learning and get educated against all odds. Dr. P.N. Singh was a vivid reader and was passionate about learning new things. He agreed to have made multiple mistakes throughout his career and used to call them as his learning experiences. He did quite well in his SSC examination, bagging the Government of India Merit Scholarship, which was awarded that year to 20 students in Bihar based on SSC marks. He then went on to study intermediate in science from Patna Science College. Later, he went to pursue BTech honors from Indian School of Mines, Dhanbad. As an uninterested student, as he felt he could have done better in economics. He then worked in Indian Oil for 11 years and proceeded to pursue an MBA in Asian Institute of Management, Manila, Philippines, in an aspiration to give justice to his leadership role. This decision resulted in gaining confidence in facing the audience and also an opportunity to improve his communication skills. In 1981, he completed his doctoral work at Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies of then Bombay University. The topic of his dissertation was a study of environmental factors related to business entrepreneurship.
Dr. Singh started his career with the Indian Oil Corporation in 1963. In 1981, he moved to Voltas Limited to head its HRD department. Later, he headed group HRD setups in Aditya Birla Group and Mehta Group. He managed to combine management development with continuous academic pursuits. He was group director HRD of Duncan Goenka Group and a member of the board of directors of two limited companies, Stone India Limited and Andhra Cement Limited. He was awarded the Andres K. Rockus Scholarship while doing his MBA and this was just a start of his celebrated career. He was later awarded a citation for academic excellence by his institute. He is the recipient of the Nature Award by his article Needed Walkabout in Management Education in 1977. In 1980, he was awarded the IMM CineFan Award for his article on oil marketing and in 1984, the Rukmini Thread Marketing Communicator of the Year Award. He was conferred the Fellowship of ISTD in 1988. He also received the Best Member Award of ISTD in the same year. Dr. Singh received the Best Paper Award of ISTD in 1991. He was inducted into the Hall of Fame at Asian Institute of Management, Manila in 1993. In March 2000, he was awarded the AIM Alumni Achievement Award. This is the highest award to be granted to an alumnus of the institute. He was also given Lifetime Achievement Award by the SIES Institute of Management Studies, Bombay in 2007. He was the first Indian to approved as an instructor to conduct grid seminars developed by Blake and Mountain in India. He had rendered training and consultancy services internationally. He was the founder chairman of the Federation of Ancient Institute of Management Alumni Association, a former president of Bombay Management Association and Indian Society of Training and Development. He was elected as President Emeritus of ISTD in 2007. Dr. Singh was actively associated with the professional management movement in India.
He was never very expressive about his emotions, at least not when I first met him. But he gave me the most precious gift when, in 2010, as we collaborated on the last self-development magazine that I worked with him on, he wrote an article titled Aisha the Great, because he was so happy to have had my help while I was in a new job at that time. And having him publicly express his compliments to me is the most precious and cherished gift I have ever gotten, and I'm sure I ever will get in the future. He used to love writing with his pen. I remember he used to tell me in his annual plan, he used to make an annual plan every year, and he used to write down bullets of the things that he wanted to achieve in that year. And he was so clear. It was a small notepad with a few bullets every year, and he wrote ambitious, simple, clear, focused ideas, and he would achieve them no matter what. I remember one of his aims was to get a Rolex watch. The last time I spoke to him on an email, he told me he had gotten his Mount Blanc pen, which was one of the things he had on his list. And even his style of expressing feedback, like I remember instances where he was having a conversation with someone and he wanted to make a point, he wanted to give some advice. And he asked me to get, one of his 20 management books over, and he flipped over to the right page and he pointed out something and he handed it over to the person in the front and asked them to read it. And that was his way of, giving feedback, of educating you, of training you to be better and to, expect better of yourself and, achieve more. As a leader, he was also extremely generous. As part of my job, I used to do sales, and I used to go to HR directors across companies to pitch our leadership seminar offerings to them. And I would usually take public transport, like the bus or the train, an auto rickshaw at times. And I remember I must have said something to him about maybe me having like a personal engagement or some sort of a personal thing that I had to get to after work. So I think I told him something around, I'm going to leave directly from the office and from the client office and go. And I remember how sweet he was, because he told his driver to drop me off and then take me to wherever I needed to go after. And that was just such a kind gesture, and he did it, at the spur of the moment, which was really special and really kind. And it taught me that he knew how to flex. He knew when to treat his employees in what particular manner, when to praise, when to appreciate, when to give feedback, when to just let them figure things out, when to, you know, ask good questions, give advice, and he just taught me all of that just by being himself and by being the leader that he was.
Hi, my name is Ezaz Patel. I had the opportunity to work for Dr. B.N. Singh at Grid Consultants while I was still completing my bachelor's degree, and I could not have asked for a better start to my career. There was this one time in our office where we were a victim of fraud, and it was completely my fault. It incurred a huge financial loss as well. And when I went to him, I was surprised that instead of yelling at me, he commended me for coming forward and admitting everything. That is the kind of integrity that he had. There was this another story, and I remember this because he chose to put this in his last book, Time Management. We were in the middle of organizing and marketing for this seminar, and I received a call from a potential attendee. This guy was asking me a lot of questions, and I spent like 45 minutes trying to answer all of them. And when I finally hung up, Dr. Singh asked me if he signed up, and I said no. And he went, "To phir kya kiya itna baat karke?" So that is something that stuck with me, because if you're going to spend that much time on a sales call, you better sign them up. Even years later now, as a father, it resonates with me that in spite of his numerous professional achievements, he nurtured his kids, who are all successful in their own right. Today, we idolize the Steve Jobses of the world, but that kind of extraordinary achievement comes at the cost of your family more often than not. If I'm able to kind of achieve that same kind of balance, that balance between professional achievement and achieving a healthy life for your kids, spending time with them, I would count myself successful. Thank you.
Despite remaining busy on the job in the corporate sector, Dr. Singh prioritized teaching in Management Institute whenever possible. At one stage, he used to teach in 7 management institutes, mostly after office hours and on weekends. Dr. Singh believed that the teaching benefited him more, as he got to learn from the students, even though there was not much money in teaching those days. He believed that the real reward was seeing the students he taught doing well in life and his thoughts on management living through them. Dr. P.N. Singh had personally trained over 6,000 senior managers in value-based leadership, like a leader who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way.
Dr. P.N. Singh also had a deep inclination towards writing. He was known to be a prolific writer. He also had, to his credit, over 600 articles on management, and his 27 books have been well received both in India and abroad. He wrote articles for different newspapers and magazines and received awards for the same. His several books went to multiple editions. He had risk-taking capabilities, which in his own words moved him to an extremely high risk capabilities, that is filmmaking. His Bhojpuri film Papi Ke Paap Kahe Ganga Dhoye was released in April 2011. The story and all 9 songs were written by Dr. P.N. Singh.
What is amazing about Dr. P.N. Singh, he always motivated young professionals. He took a lot of personal care. He guided them properly in their career. As a writer, this is another role which he played, and he has written a number of books, more than 20 books. But one or two books which I would like to mention, which played a very important role in the students' life, especially MBA students' life, and I would strongly recommend it to read, because these, I must have distributed more than 1,000 copies to my students at Indian Business School, IBS, Parle Tilak Vidyalaya, Saket Institute, and other places. The name of the book is Bullock Car to Mercedes. That is his journey, starting from Bihar to Bombay, where he owned Mercedes, and he was very passionate about it, and he liked it, and he always said that this is my journey and this is my final outcome. So this is one book which talks about his journey, but the message is very clear that if you are committed, you can achieve anything.
Dr. P.N. Singh believed in distributing whatever he earned, and thus he initiated Janmabhoomi Karmabhoomi Abhiyan. He believes that you must contribute to the upliftment of Karmabhoomi, the place where you work and earn your living, and Janmabhoomi, where you were born. Dr. P.N. Singh Foundation was set up in the year 1997 with an initiative to work in Mumbai and enrich the lives of the poor and meritorious students, taking them to newer heights. With a donation from him, Dr. P.N. Singh Foundation undertook a Leaders of Tomorrow project for school children from economically backward families studying in 32 schools in Mumbai suburbs. It has also introduced the Indian Scholar Awards, under which the education of over 60 students are being funded by the foundation. He started Sri Bishwanath Singh Memorial Educational and Welfare Trust in memory of his late father in 1987. Presently, the trust is providing educational assistance to several students coming from an economically backward segment of the society. The trust had also set up the first self-development center in his village in Bihar, in a rural setting. A computer center, a tailoring school, houses for poor men and women are other activities of the trust under the Janmabhoomi Karmabhoomi Abhiyan.
Okay. Okay. Professor Jigar.
Violeta, can you just play it from the Janmabhoomi Karmabhoomi Abhiyan?
We had started. We had started. Jigar, can we have it from
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, Violeta.
Yes, sir. I'll do that.
Yeah, can you just play from that Janmabhoomi Karmabhoomi Abhiyan?
Yes, yes. But can someone enable me for screen sharing?
Yeah. Lakshmi ji, can you just
make the co-host? Sir. Yeah. Yeah, it's done, sir.
Yeah.
Violeta, now do you Violeta,
yeah.
So, is it visible?
Yeah, it's visible. Yeah, that's the right. Yeah,
you can start from. Other activities of the trust under the Janmabhoomi Karmabhoomi Abhiyan.
Yes, I am. P.N. Singh comes from a small village in Bihar. It's a place called Ganj in Ikmar, Chhapra district. And he himself came from a very underprivileged background, very poor background, but he became successful. He felt that let's focus on Janbhumi and Karmbhumi. What comes under Janbhumi is he felt that, you know, the place that you're born in, you need to do something back for that. And our philosophy has been education, irrigation, and accommodation. And under Karmbhumi, the place which gave you your livelihood, Dr. P.N. Singh thought that, you know, what can I give back to Maharashtra and Bombay? Now, while he was recruiting in a company, he had recruited more than 4,000 managers. And the philosophy of the organization was that, you know, if their communication skills were not good, however competent they may be, you need to not hire them. And that's what was one of the first steps which triggered him, that, you know, he could see himself in them, and he felt really bad having to reject them. So he says, what can I give them? And that's how this whole Leaders of Tomorrow project started.
Dr. P.N. Singh was a very renowned management thinker. He inspired all of us with his wonderful thoughts on how people could give off their best potential. I first met him during the course of my work at the Bombay Management Association. I happened to be a very, very old past president, and Dr. P.N. Singh was an inspirational president of the association. He introduced me to the concepts of how can you actually trace and determine what he called at that time the grid of capabilities of people, and how can you harness each one of those capabilities to bring to bear on an organization's success. To me, he was so completely immersed in bringing out the highest potential of the human being that that trait itself made him the leader that he was. Today, as I see the world and as I see the future, one of the greatest capitals that the whole human race needs to enhance is human capital. It is one of the six capitals which defines what is now coming to be known as integrated reporting. And if Dr. P.N. Singh was with us today, I'm sure he would have led the thrust into making sure that the entire human mind was in a position to actually bring value, curate, improve, enhance, and put to great value the human capital. So I salute his memory. I give great good wishes to his family. And above all, I congratulate all of you for making sure that his memory continues and the benefit of his work and his thoughts get widely known to the student and other communities that you will access. Thank you very much.
Dr. P.N. Singh, the man who grew up in very humble surroundings in Bihar, rose to become an icon in the management world. He never looked back in life, even though he was from the vernacular Hindi medium schooling. He rose to be one of the best known speakers. So Hindi medium did not bother him, neither did the vernacular background of his bothered him as far as eloquence in speaking was concerned, because he knew the subject very well. And that man really, really prepared so well that his eloquence was super. And a good leader, is known by the leaders he creates. And a simple example about my own life is what I would like to narrate. When I was a very new young member at the Bombay Management Association, he used to head the program committee, which was very, very well known and good, one of the good committees of BMA. And he invited me to join the committee. And in short, at every occasion, that he got, he put me on the desk either to propose a word of thanks or speak or introduce the speaker. And that quality in him was one thing which I admired and subsequently ensured that I will become the chairman of the same committee the next year. And he kept on mentoring me till I became the president of the BMA. This is what PN Singh is all about. His leadership quality is par excellence. Mentoring is part of a passion in him. He mentored people who mattered, people who where he saw a spark within them. And he made sure that they rise in whatever field that they were in. And this was an additional quality in PN Singh.
Dr. PN Singh was the chairman of Grid Consultant Private Limited. He was based in Mumbai till he left for his heavenly abode on 19th September 2013. He also acknowledged that his wife was his biggest support system throughout his career and achievements, as she never interfered with his passion for work. Dr. PN Singh's grandfather would always say that he would become a Hakim Hukam, which means a big officer, and he was proven right. We, the 21st century people, constantly blame the timing and luck for our failures, even though we are so privileged. Thus, one of the eye-opener things I learned from Dr. PN Singh's journey is that being underprivileged or privileged wouldn't define us. Rather, we must keep igniting the fire inside us to keep learning and achieving. Giving justice to the statement, which is, successful people are not gifted, they just work hard and succeed on purpose. While reading through the book, I came across a very critical aspect that Dr. PN Singh never blamed the timing or his work environment. Rather, he made his bad experiences a lesson for life and made sure that no other person would face the bad experiences he encountered by writing books on the same. Making reading his addiction was indeed one of the best decisions for him, and so it is for all of us today. Dr. PN Singh is an epitome of hardworking, determined, selfless person. We are highly grateful to be given this opportunity to know about this great man and learn from him.
Thank you for that very elaborate, and you have got the personality almost for all of us. Thank you PTVIM for this, and now we will have the experiences of many who have had good fortune to work with Dr. PN Singh. Our immediate past president, Professor RSS Mani, he has special tie up with Dr. PN Singh, and I'm sure all his connections that he is going to bring it to us will be a lesson to learn from. And I'll request Professor RSS Mani to please tell us about his learnings and experiences with Dr. PN Singh. Over to you, sir.
Namaskar. Good evening, everybody, and thank you, Kavita. Compliments to the team for having produced such a lovely audiovisual film on Dr. PN Singh. But trust me, the more you read about Dr. Singh, the more you listen about Dr. Singh, the more you experience about him, you realize that he was an ocean of knowledge. And he had this very, very favorite statement that knowledge should be multiplied, otherwise it would disappear. And I think this is precisely an organization like a BMA, like an ISTD, or an NHRDN is exactly doing the same. Such a visionary person. It was a blessing for me that I could spend a lot of time learning under him and got this unique fortune to work along with him on several training projects, and more importantly, work on the several projects that he initiated for the benefit of the underprivileged under the Leaders of Tomorrow, which was such a divine project to emancipate the underprivileged. To take a trip down memory lane, Dr. Singh was our visiting professor at the Tata Institute of Social Sciences when I was a student way back in 1986. And the best thing in his classes, as was also mentioned by one of the speakers, he used to be very forthcoming, blunt, and direct. He never hesitated to call a spade a spade. And that's what made his classes very, very interesting and very, very enjoyable. Subsequently, I had a little shock when the selection panel for my appointment at Tata Institute of Social Sciences had Dr. P.N. Singh as one of the expert committee members. And I just didn't know what to feel, because seeing him there was a feeling of awe. But subsequently, once I joined up the institute, there were several occasions to bring him to the institute to talk to the students, to be part of conferences and seminars. And in those days, there used to be a Tridev in the field of training and development. And I'm delighted to note that two of them have already been profiled as living legends, I would call them, in the field of training and development as part of the BMA initiative. The Tridev were Dr. P.N. Singh, Professor Y.K. Bhushan, and Professor Sharu Rangnekar. These were the three people who were perhaps part of every conference in training and development and human resource development. You couldn't have an event without having at least one of them or two of them. And these three people contributed significantly. But what still made Dr. Singh very, very special was his ability to connect with everybody, his humility, his approach to building networks. And as Aisha said somewhere, he would be happy to introduce one person to another. He would be happy to connect one organization to another. And that's what made a very special person out of Dr. P.N. Singh. I still recall, and I'm mentioning this particularly, he introduced me to Mr. Walter Vieira, who has been gracing BMA forums very frequently and is part of the team which has set up this entire project. And then on, it's been a relationship with Mr. Walter Vieira continuing over three decades now. That was the kind of intent, the good intent that Dr. P.N. Singh always had. Subsequently, as I mentioned, I had the unique opportunity to work with him both in the training fraternity, in the leadership seminars under the GRID seminars, went on to connect with him with our institute, ITM Group of Institutions, where he was on our board of advisors. So there was always an opportunity to interact with him and enrich oneself. The hallmark of his career, I believe, which is so different from anybody else that one would profile, was his concept of what we call Dena Bank. We did speak about LED, learn, earn, distribute, but his favorite word was, you should be a Dena Bank. Lena Bank mat bano. Sabhi log paise lete rehte hain. Lekin aap paise kisi ko dete ho kya? Samaj seva mein lagate ho kya? Apna samay bitate ho kya? Were fundamental questions he would always ask. And his favorite line whenever he met me is, so Professor Mani, are you making a lot of money? When are you giving something to our Dena Bank? And this was always a hallmark of the person's intent to reach out to society. Karma Bhumi, Janma Bhumi, we've heard so much about it, be it the entire wonderful work around the Santa Cruz belt where he used to stay and where his office was, down to his village in deep district of Bihar. The intent was always, can I give world-class education to children so that they become world-class citizens and make India proud? Delighted that over 20 years, we had scholarships initiated with the Leaders of Tomorrow project and ITM, courtesy our chairman, Dr. Ramana, where many students have done education till their terminal degree with the ITM schools across the country. In fact, as I was listening to our senior colleagues, be it Sailesh Bhai or Bhaskar Joshi, one just suddenly realized that so many people whom Dr. P.N. Singh had perhaps interacted with had perhaps guided, motivated, inspired, actually were blessed with presidentship of BMA. And I think I am one of those included, is what just struck me when we were listening to all these stalwarts across sharing their experiences. Last but not the least, whenever I think of Dr. Singh, the first thought that comes to mind is, what can I contribute to make society a better place? And this is something he always felt was his mission, was his journey of life. Everything else did matter to him. Like colleague said, he had this dream of a Mont Blanc pen, a Rolex watch, and a Mercedes car. And I think he achieved all of it, notwithstanding the challenges that he went through, considering the background, which he always used to talk about. But he also ensured what one had read in a very beautiful essay a couple of years back, that when you do well in life, when you prosper, you certainly improve your standard of living. But what is more important, you should also improve your standard of giving. And I think this is what Dr. Singh epitomized right through his life journey. It's a blessing and honor for me to remember him here this evening, particularly as a person whom we always carry in our hearts forever. Dr. Singh, thank you for your blessings, and we look forward to it always. Namaskar.
Thank you, Professor RSS Mani. I think you rightly mentioned that Hriday or Trimurti of training and development, and we have already presented the personality, Dr. Sharu Rangnekar, and believe me that the next personalities include Dr. Y.K. Bhushan, and we all are aware that we lost him very recently. Thank you very much for sharing your learnings and the thought of giving back to the society in any form, I think, has been the motivation of Dr. P.N. Singh. I'm very happy today that we have daughters of Dr. P.N. Singh, Dr. Anita Shantaram and Sunita Chuk. I will request Sunita first to say a few words. Tell us about her father and her fond memories about him and the learnings that will be very, very relevant for the management students who are on this call and the young the management graduates who all are listening to this particular conversation. So over to you, Sunita.
Professor Kavita, thank you very much. I see Walter Vieira sir, Ernest Fernandez sir, Indrapal sir. So I'm hoping that I'm not interrupting their presentation. I would urge the elders to speak first, if possible, Kavita ma'am, and I'm here on the call throughout. So
the format of our program is that our mentors, Mr. Walter Vieira, Professor Ernest Fernandez, and Indrapalji will speak at the end. So okay. We would like to know about all your impressions, sure. Your experiences.
Thank you, Professor Kavita.
They will be speaking in some time. Yeah.
Yes, thank you so much. The reason I shared that is, I think the one thing that today I'm very mindful of is the quality of respect that I learned from my father. The point about humility has been raised many times. My father respected one and all, and especially his elders, unconditionally. And that is something that I'm feeling in my heart right now. The lesson that I learned from him was, I'll share three stories very quickly. One, I always remember him lying down on a Sunday afternoon, getting up, having his cup of tea, and dictating an article or a chapter of a book full speed. I even learned shorthand because of him. And I was only in school and college at that time. And my friends used to tease me, will you become a secretary? And I used to say, I don't mind becoming a secretary because it is so wonderful to learn directly from a teacher. It was almost like textbooks and articles were downloaded into me when I was in school. So very many times I ask myself, where did I learn HRD or HR first? And I think I learned English language, I learned mathematics, I learned rapid fire writing shorthand, and anything to do with management first from my father while I was in school. And I'm talking of the years 1977 to 1989-90 when I used to take these dictations. And I was still in school and college and then later on in MBA. The second story, and I always remember him horizontal. I don't remember him ever standing or sitting and dictating this. It was always lying down and doing restfully. You know, very restfully Saraswati would enter him and he would be able to. Later on, after 90, when I got married, I noticed he used to write a lot more. You know, he used to directly write with his pen and paper. And not that he didn't write earlier, but whenever he had intense thoughts, I noticed he did it very restfully and he dictated it. Today we have technology and this is for the youngsters. Please write a voice note. Please write and record your words if you're not able to use pen and paper or directly on a, you know, on a document. Speak about it, then try and transcribe it. You will always get it better. And I think that's one lesson that I want to share with the management students also. The second point that I wanted to, is a memory that I wanted to share about him was, even when he went for his walks or he did shirsasana and yoga and exercise, and he went to, you know, Landmark Forum very early when it was Est in India, I remember that he invested a lot in himself and his own development from many different. He was not a religious person, he was quite agnostic, but he would go to temples with mummy because mummy wanted him to go, or he would just go for a walk, or he would go for est. And many of these different dimensions he would bring into his writing. I remember him taking a walk with his hand always moving. So that's one image I have of him, that he could think. And he has been called a thinker, but he could think while he was doing any activity and he would bring it back in a very focused manner into the work that was at hand. And usually, 9 times out of 10, I have seen visionary leaders not be able to execute. But he was one of those people which everybody who worked with him will agree that he was a hands-on manager. He would do it himself. If somebody was missing, he was ready to roll up his sleeves and act on something. So I think it came from deep thought and execution. He was able to tie it together. So many of the management education students that I know are very good thinkers and imaginative people with a lot of ideas. But unless you put it down to execution, there is no point. So if you have 10 ideas, like Aisha mentioned in the video, he would make sure he executed all the 10. So you can't be a visionary leader without knowing how to execute your dreams or without knowing how to execute your passion or your thoughts. The third thing that I would like to call out today is his need for precision. I think in this world of people talking a lot, he was one person who was doing a lot. He would talk, but he would talk only when he was called upon. And I think that is one lesson that I want to pass on. We all use our tongue very easily. But Dr. Singh was one person who used his tongue only either when he was paid for or he was invited to talk or only when it mattered. And I have seen him talk to audience of 5,000 with just 3 points. He would say, I want to make only 3 points. And I think Professor Mani also mentioned Tridev, and I'm thinking of the Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. The power of three he taught me. And as I close this memory, there's lots and lots that I can talk about as a daughter and as a child who grew up in his house. This point about being able to very powerfully pass on what he has to pass on through just a very simple message. So that precision requires a lot of homework. So in closing, I would like to call out three of his qualities: simplicity, straightforwardness, and his studiousness. And I think my entire focus was on education, because as an educationist, he's left a legacy behind, and I hope I can do a drop in the ocean of what he was. So thank you so much, Professor Kavita, for giving me this opportunity, and BMA for doing this Wisdom Wednesdays, and for each student who has worked to make this a success. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sunita, for those very interesting and very thoughtful memories of yours, and the learnings that you have underlined while speaking, I think, are lessons for all of us to follow. I will invite now Anita to talk about another aspects of Dr. P.N. Singh, which we would like to know from her as a daughter, student, and the person who is working on the dreams of Dr. P.N. Singh.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. So keeping his lesson of time management, from my three lessons, I've made it two. And I'll share only two stories about him, two lessons that I have learned. One was when I was graduating, I wanted to dedicate my life to social service. And I told Dad that I want to do only social service. And he said, no, you must have a career because you must generate wealth to contribute wealth. It's very easy to do charity with other people's money, and you must generate it. So that was lesson one for me. The second one which I want to share is that hard work and integrity pays. I remember the time we used to live in Pali Hill with hardly any furniture in our house because he used to contribute for society development and Bihar and all of that. And he went on to become one of the highest paid HR professionals, the most well-known name in HR. And seeing that whole journey upfront, we lived it. So if anyone says that there are shortcuts to success, no, we saw it. Him working tremendously hard every day of his life. And that's what is my second lesson. So I can only say that we didn't inherit money from him. What we inherited was hard work. Today, if my sister and me have done our PhD, she in leadership, me in ethics, I think both of this is what reflects Dad, and it's our tribute to him, and it's our gift to him, because we could give nothing other than that. So I feel that continuing hard work is the only tribute that we can give to our dad. So thank you, Dad. He was my role model, is my role model, because I think what I am or what Didi is also is only because of him. So thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Anita. We have listened to both the daughters. I will request if anyone in the call would like to speak about the experiences with Dr. P.N. Singh, they can raise the hands. And in the meantime, I will request Walter Vieira sir to say his connection with Dr. P.N. Singh.
Well, I've had a long association with Dr. Singh, well over, I think, nearly 40 years that we've been associated. He started with inviting me to be the marketing consultant in virtually every company that he joined as the head of personnel or HR. And therefore, we worked together in most of the companies that he worked for. We shared a lot of common interests in writing books and giving talks. But, you know, a lot has been said about him during this session, all of it very true. There's very little more to say, except I want to reemphasize one. And that is, you know, in a world which we are facing now, surrounded by frauds, every day, every week, every month, frauds, corporate frauds, individual frauds in the corporate world and in government. And in a world where people do a lot of bootlicking, lack of integrity, P.N. Singh would stand out as completely different. His integrity was unquestionable. His fault could be that he was so straight and so frank that he could be brutally frank. He did not couch, you know, his disagreement in very sweet words, that you realize it only much later that he did not agree with you at all. If he disagreed, he disagreed right there and then and explained why he did so. These are two qualities which I greatly appreciated. I've seen him, for example, we all three of us used to meet quite often, Rangnekar, P.N. Singh and I. And he used to have great arguments with Charu Rangnekar. Really wild, losing tempers. The moment the argument was over, it was all back to the beginning. They were great friends, warm, as if nothing had happened. I don't see this very often now. This being so frank and yet and so honest. I will never forget the many, many situations where he taught me this lesson over and over again of high integrity and lack of inclination to lick boots to get where he wanted to go. He had always some material aspirations, not just the spiritual ones or the social ones. Of course he wanted to wear a Rolex watch. Of course he wanted a Mercedes. And I used to wonder, why is he fretting for these seemingly materialistic, showing off goals? And I realized he just wanted to show or work the whole period from bullock cart to Mercedes Benz. He wanted to prove to himself and to others that he has done it. But at the same time, while doing this and enjoying it, because he did not rob to buy these things, he did it the fair way. He still never forgot the poor and the unfortunate, to lend a helping hand to them, both monetarily and emotionally. That's the way I would think of P.N. Singh. And again, I remember him very, very fondly, and I miss him. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
I finished.
Yes, thank you very much for your words and your experiences with Dr. P.N. Singh. I think he has a peculiar personality of giving a tagline to each and every lesson that he wanted to give. And we are listening from all of you that the way he has used these words, very impressive and very, very hard-hitting to remember. Thank you so much for your sharing. I will request Atul Chugh to speak. He has raised the hand. So over to you.
Thank you, Kavita ma'am. I'm new to this BMA webinar or the situation here, but I thought let me tag along with Anita and Sunita. I am Dr. Singh's son-in-law, and I'm married to Sunita. So my memory, and it's a nice moment for me to remember one personal anecdote. I was dating Sunita in college, and we were both classmates in Kodar College. And I remember, and he was larger than life at that time. He was in Voltas, huge person. And he called me, he sent a message, and he said, Atul, I want to meet you. I thought he's heard about Sunita and me going, he will shout at me and he will do all kinds of things. So me and my friends were really preparing for this meeting. And I go to him, it is only me and him in the living room, and Sunita is not there, Anita is not there. Mrs. Singh is also not there. So it was only me, man to man. And he asks me, the first thing he asks me is, what's your intention, young man? So I said, my intention is very, very honest and direct. I would like to marry your daughter. And I would like to, be with her and all that couple of statements which I had made ready, like a small slip I had taken with me. And he said that I trust you. I value what you're saying directly. And I hope both of you, you know, remain together and be together and things like that. You know, he blessed me at that moment. So that was one thing which I really liked. And I heard Varela sir say that. So it's very, very direct, very honest, to the point, and straight from thinking to execution. And the next question he asked me is, when will we get married? So there is hardly any gap between the thinking, understanding of the situation and assessment or the evaluation of the person, nothing. It's just cut, cut, cut in a very sequential way and straight to the action. When will the marriage happen? So that is that, and I'm not prepared for it. So it was amazing to meet him in person from that perspective. And I think what I really like about him was his sense of curiosity. So he was not only curious about learning new things, doing new things, writing new things, but he was also curious about people. Not only people from, you know, Professor R.S.S. Mani or his professional colleagues or Professor Y.K. Bhushan, not only from that perspective, but from his relatives also. So he knew what his, you know, uncle or his cousin or his nephew is doing in Bihar. He also knew what my family members are doing, and my family is big. Anita's family from Rahul's side is a very big, but he knew everyone. He was curious to know what they're doing, what are they learning, what MBA course are they doing, who's studying what. And always he used to be, you know, encouraging us to do more for the society, learn more and earn more. So the LED principle is what he, you know, kind of spread throughout my family also. So this is the right occasion to say a big thank you to him for being in my life through Sunita. And, you know, and being able to be with Anita and Sunita, you know, together. Thank you. Thank you, Kavitaji, for giving me an opportunity to say that.
Thank you. You give a very different perspective to this discussion, because you and Anita's husband can be on that side, but everyone else can be on the other side. So thank you so much for sharing that, and the way you perceive Dr. P.N. Singh from the very different perspective in, as a family member, but a son-in-law. So thank you, Atul, for coming on to this webinar. And we are happy to say that Bombay Management Association is doing these series, and you can have a look at it in our BMA YouTube channel also. And do join us for other webinars also. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll request Professor Ernest Fernandez to say a few words about his perception, understanding, and experiences with Dr. PNC.
Thank you. In fact, much has been said about Dr. Singh's LED formula. And I think that the L and the E are practiced by most managers. Learning and earning is the name of the game. So what was really different about Dr. Singh was the D part. And the D, he did it in a big way. I mean, not just in a small way. And at the same time, as Walter and Professor Mani have pointed out, he liked the good things in life. Now, I don't know how much, he couldn't have shared his Rolex watch and his Montblanc pen with Sunita and Anita, but I'm sure he must have allowed them to use his Mercedes. I'd like to know more about that. I also thought that this question of, he didn't say too much according to Sunita. He was not a man who talked unnecessarily. But I remember when I was in 1997, I was the president of BMA. And as part of Management Week, because that's one occasion which BMA members look forward to meet their friends and attend talks, we decided to have a talk on humor and management. And I remember very well that immediately the people who came to my mind were Dr. P.N. Singh and Mr. Sharu Ragnetha and Mr. Pramod Batra, who at that time was Delhi-based and a lot of cartoons and management. And it was an extremely serious discussion on humor management, in the sense that they brought up why humor management was so important. And that really was an eye-opener. I'd also like to say that Dr. Singh was thinking ahead of his time, because we've had a controlled economy for many years in India. And somewhere in February of 92, he rang me up And he told me that, look, you know, I want to organize a seminar together with a magazine called Perspective on the subject of innovation in management, a constructive need. So I said, fine, but whom else are you going to invite? So he said, I'm going to invite Mr. Y.K. Bhushan, and I'm going to invite Mr. Ashok Sharma, who also participate. And you will talk about innovation and marketing, because as we are going into globalization, a liberalized economy, we require to innovate in each of these areas. So I took on marketing, Ashok Sharma took on manufacturing and research, and Professor Y.K. Bhushan took on HRD. And I've got this magazine with me here in my hands called Perspective, which I've retained for so many years, where there's a big photograph, and Perspective published all the proceedings. So that just shows how he was already thinking ahead of his time. And so I'd like to say that my association with Dr. Singh has been one which was something I always looked forward to, because I knew that when I met him, he would always be saying something which I had not even thought about, and which I certainly would have learned something from. And I would like to, one can see in the family he has, that he has passed on his values to his children, which I think some managers are too busy in their own professions and not having time for their family. But he made the time for his family and passed on his values to his family, who are carrying on his values, which I think would be a source of great satisfaction for him.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Fernandez. I will request Professor Indrapal ji to say a few words about his experiences with Dr. P.N. Singh. You're on mute, sir. Unmute yourself.
Dr. Singh was a tall person, both physically and intellectually. And I think he did not suffer ordinariness in thinking to the extent possible. And he was therefore pretty direct and sharp, I would say. We used to meet regularly at BMS functions and some of conferences and seminars of about human resources topics and so on. Though HR is not my topic, and so occasionally I would attend those seminars and meetings to broaden my own perspectives. But BMA definitely, BMA's events we used to definitely meet. He had also conducted managerial grid seminars for my company, that is at Godrej & Boys, Blake & Newton, and they were very much liked. He had also conducted, if I recall right, a few seminars on situational leadership as well. So three things stand out, like Sunita mentioned, the restless energy. You know, he would not stand still, or he would be constantly thinking, and he exuded a lot of energy. I mean, that energy field, if you have to be in to experience it, very few people have such level of high energy. The second was, of course, the sense of humor that Ernest mentioned. I did not attend that seminar, but I remember him, Tarun Sheth, and others would have whopping time, you know, at some of the get-togethers over drinks or dinner and things like that. And the third thing that I learned from him, or rather I remember about him, is great ability to coin these acronyms. So you all heard LED. Other day, I think she was mentioning to me about one STD also, but the one that I recall is HER, H-E-R. And he used that acronym, and then I asked him, Dr. Singh, what is that, HER, you know? So he said H is for heterogeneous, E is for externalization, and R is for rationalization. So I said, but how does it connect with whatever we are talking? So he said, we have a tendency in India to always give a reason for something. You know, you ask somebody why this thing is done or not done, we give a reason. So he said, first, one of the kind of category of reasons we give is we are heterogeneous. So, you know, this Western learning, Western thinking, these concepts don't apply to us. We are heterogeneous. It may apply in urban areas, not in rural areas and things like that. So this we'll give as a reason. Second thing, if something goes wrong in a country, it will say it is because of the external causes. Pakistan is doing that, US is doing that, and so on and so forth. You know, the foreign hand that even Congress is talking about. And the third is rationalization. So rationalization is a kind of cooking up good reasons and ignoring the true reasons. So he said, we are very good at that. You ask somebody, how come somebody is late? He would never admit that he started late from home. He would say, no, there's too much of traffic. The train was late. I fell down on the way to office and stuff like that. I had to buy my emergency medicines and whatnot for my kids and stuff like that. So he said, we are great rationalizers. Nobody will admit to the true reasons. And he said, that is one of the reasons we do not learn to face reality, and that not knowing the reality holds us back. So there are several. One other day, Shantaram was mentioning that there are many more he has coined. I think you can make a glossary of those acronyms and share with it. Other experience I have with is that, as already mentioned, he was a prolific writer. I think you would write probably an article a week or a fortnight. So BMA used to have one printed magazine called Ambit. And whenever we would request him for a contribution, without betting an eyelid, he would agree to contribute and write a lovely article, 4 pages long, 1,500, 2,000 words long, and contribute, but never refusing to do so. Likewise, even whenever BMA would organize a conference or HR summit or something, he would be the first one to accept our invitation and say, yes, I'll be there. And once people would read his name that he's participating, they would also come because they know that the quality of discussions, etc., would be very high. So in my view, he was a true karma yogi who lived life according to his principles. And another small observation I want to make, his love of precision. If you really, his three favorite things, Montblanc pen, the watch, Rolex watch, and the Mercedes, both have German origins. And Germany has been known for precision. So it's a very good, I think somewhere he must have related his need to be precise with the symbols of precision rather than symbols of having arrived kind of a thing. So he was a wonderful person to know. And I think, we should all remember him and probably learn more from his books and discussions and things like that. And in closing, I would like to thank the students who put in all this work to make an audiovisual, and the family members and Professor Mani and others who came and spoke to all BMA members and brought about a completely new dimension of a modern manager, what he can do. He can do both the things simultaneously. He can earn as he wants. He can set his physical goals of how much money he should make. And at the same time, he could have another set of goals as to how much he can contribute to the society. So all in all, he was a complete man in that sense. Thank you.
Thank you, Indrapalji, for those remarks. And truly, what we have heard and learned from all the discussion that we had, that a person who has come from a very humble background, from rural India, can achieve all those Rolex watch and the Mercedes and contribute back to the society, and continued after him also with the sanskar that he has given to his daughters and the fellow people who had worked with him and got the learnings from the personality. Today we have many management students who are in this call. I think the learning that we are getting as a personality is that the society will survive if we nurture it and if we contribute to the development of the society. Coming from Bihar, thinking about the small village and making a project which is Janmabhoomi and Karmabhoomi is a novel idea. Many of us migrate for education, for job, and then we forget our roots. the personality today is exhibiting that no need to forget anything. You can still be there with both. You can belong to both. He belonged to Bihar as well as he made his career and he contributed in Mumbai also. Great learnings. Thank you very much for contributing to this webinar of Bombay Management Association in a series of celebrating Indian managers who made the difference. Thank you, Anita. Thank you, Sunita. Atul, thanks are due to you also. A special thank. All the students of Parle Tirath Vidyalaya Association's Institute of Management, Director Dr. Harish Kumar Purohit, all the professors along with Jigar and our mentors, Mr. Walter Vieira, Professor Ernest Fernandez, and Sri Indrapal Ji, for your guidance. Next month, last Wednesday of the month, we are going to present to you Mr. F.C. Kohli, another personality which will be again celebrating the Indianness and the leaders or the managers who had made the difference. Do join us on the last Wednesday for celebrating Indian managers. But in the meantime, have a look at our YouTube channel, Bombay Management Association's YouTube channel. There are over 180 interesting videos that you can have a look at. Every Wednesday and every Friday, we come up with Wednesday Wisdom Webinar and Friday Fundamentals. There is a series, another series going on of Bombay Management Association's Masterclass. Do join us for that. Subscribe to Bombay Management Association's YouTube channel. Keep visiting, keep learning, and happy learning to all of us. Thank you so much. Before we close, I will request all of you to keep your video on for a moment, memory of this particular event for smiling BMA moments. Thank you all, and we'll stop here. Do join us on next Wednesday for experiencing the coaching experience with International Coaching Federation and Bombay Management Association. Do join us at 5 o'clock on Wednesday and Friday for these webinars. Thank you very much.
Good evening, Walter.
Hi.
Hi there.
Yeah. Hi.
Where did you find that perspective?
Where did you find that?